precise sample by using this kind of stratified sampling technique, where you get a more reliable sample and a more sample which is more precise. So here diagrammatically, this is how it is shown. This is a heterogeneous population. You find orange, you find pink, you find green, you find blue. So there is variety in this population. So there is, in this population will be called as heterogeneous population. So you first divide the population into strata, that is different groups. So blue will form one group, green, pink, and orange the other groups. Then from each group, each stratum, you will select randomly and include that into your sample. So this is how your stratified sampling technique is to be followed to select your sample from the population. So how do you do this grouping of the population? How do you divide the population into different strata? So you can take various characteristics, like on the basis of income, you can divide your population into different subgroups, on the basis of age, or on the basis of occupation, or on the basis of gender. So any demographic variables you can take, married, unmarried, marital status. So like any demographic variable. So you can take profession. So you can divide your population into strata on the basis of any of these characteristics. And each strata should be different from each other. And then you follow the simple random sampling technique. And from each stratum, you randomly select one sample to be included into your population. So the sample size, what should be the sample size you should take from the population? What proportion your sample size should be in proportion to the population? We have to follow a formula. So suppose you take the sample size small n is equal to 30. You want a sample of 30 from a population which is capital N 8000. So from a population of 8000, you want to draw out a sample of 30. So how do you do that? So you divide the population into three strata, three groups, subgroups. You divide the population. So N1 will be 4000, N2 will be 2400, and N3 will be 1600. So for your strata N1, 4000, what is the formula you should apply to draw the sample from that stratum? So you take pi is equal to small n into brackets capital N1 divided by n. So here, small n1 is equal to n. N is your sample size, which you want. So that is 30. So pi is equal to 30. And capital N1 is your subgroup of the population, that is 4000, divided by capital N. That is your population size. So your population size is 8000. So that is equal to 15. So you got your first sample for this capital N1 subgroup or strata. You got your first sample, that is 15. So same way you calculate the sample sizes for capital N2 and capital N3. So which will be 9 and 6. So like this, you can get a sample size for different strata, which is in proportion to the population size. So this formula has to be followed in stratified sampling technique to draw out a proportionate sample from the population, which is proportionate to the population and which is a more precise sample and more accurate sample. So the dividing the population into different subgroups, like I told you, demographic characteristics you can take, there are so many demographic characteristics. So for example, you want to do a survey of the attitude of students towards a new teaching plan. So you want to find out the attitude of students towards a new teaching plan. So you take the colleges, which is a population of 20 colleges, and then you stratify those colleges, the students in those colleges, you stratify it into different groups on the basis of maybe class, section, or on the basis of college itself. So then from each strata, then you draw the sample to form which is proportionate to the population. So this is called as cross stratification. It's more reliable a kind of sample, because here the different colleges, 20 colleges are there, students are studying in different classes, different sections. So that is why it is called as cross stratification. So you are taking students from different sections, from different classes, and from different colleges, and then you are randomly selecting from each strata some students to be included into your sample. So first you are stratifying the population. That means you are dividing the population into subgroups. So first step is stratification. Then second step is randomly selecting your elements to form your sample. So you are applying the technique of simple random sampling technique. So that is why this sampling technique is known as stratified random sampling technique, where you are applying stratification and then simple random sampling to get your sample from the population. So what is the advantages of stratified sampling? It is more popular technique because you are dividing the population into different strata. That is, you are dividing the population into different subgroups, and then from each subgroup, through simple random sampling technique, you are selecting randomly some elements to be included into your sample. So it is a more accurate way of taking a sample from the population, more efficient way. So it is easy to calculate, and it is easy to take out sample, which is a more precise sample, by using this stratified random sampling technique. Then what are the disadvantages? Disadvantage of this stratified random sampling technique is, first, the researcher should know everything about the population. How many variants are there in the population? That is, how heterogeneous the population is, how much variety is there in the population, what is the size of the population. All this he should have complete knowledge of it. So then only he can do successfully this stratified random sampling technique. So that is why this technique is more expensive, because first the researcher has to collect information about the population, then he has to divide the population into different subgroups, that is strata, and then he has to randomly select elements from each stratum to form his sample. So he has to put his efforts, time, and money to carry out this sampling technique. So when he is dividing the population into different subgroups, he can make a mistake. He may include wrong elements into the wrong group. When he is doing classification of different groups, maybe he will wrongly put some elements into some groups. So such kind of mistakes can happen. So that these are the disadvantages of using this stratified sampling technique. Even though it is very precise technique, you get a more reliable sample, you get a more efficient sample from the population, even though it is a better sampling technique compared to others it is involve its disadvantage is that you need to have complete information of the population. You need to spend your time, effort, and money in carrying out this sampling technique. And when you are classifying the population, can you hear me?